My view of the exchange is that it's a marketplace plus. So it's a mechanism. My vision of it is it's a mechanism where people can come, unlike the traditional insurance marketplace, to purchase health coverage or enroll in a public program. So my vision of it is the no wrong door plus kind of thing. And what I mean by that is the exchange is a place that's supposed to be where people can come, whether they're eligible for a public program, private insurance, or they may already be insured and want to switch plans. So it has to be, the exchange has to be a place where all of those people can come and feel comfortable and educated about what they can select and not select. But the plus is, to me, that there needs to be, or there should be, added value to the consumers going there. And that means it isn't a traditional insurance marketplace, and it isn't the traditional Medicaid enrollment. It's direct assistance with the consumers. It's answering their questions up front. It's helping them pick plans. And it's also using whatever leverage we have to try to drive down the cost of care. So that's what I mean by the plus. OHA has its own role and actually statutory requirement to educate people about their rights under health plans. And we also have a role because of the ACA. We are the consumer assistance program for the state of Connecticut under the Affordable Care Act. So we have a role there where we're supposed to educate people about the ACA and their rights under, people's rights under those, under the Affordable Care Act and health reform in general. But then, and then we have a role, I see, on the exchange to do that, and OHA specifically has an agreement with the exchange to undertake the navigator and in-person assistance component of the requirements under the exchange to reach out to people and enroll them. And that is heavy, intense work down at the ground level in the communities to get people educated, engage them, and have them be educated with respect to the programs that are offered. Connecticut has had a series of efforts to try to reform the healthcare system, and each one of them has gone kind of right to the edge and then not been able to kind of jump over the barrier. And so it has raised expectations a lot in all communities, particularly I think in the consumer community. We want something to work. So some of the challenges may revolve around history and trying to separate what's going on now from history, but also build on the history that we've had and the experience that we've had in the state, particularly the consumer advocacy piece, which is very robust in Connecticut. Another challenge I would say is that we're kind of ingrained here in Connecticut. We have a very heavy insurance presence here, as you know. Can be a good thing, could also be a thing that is a barrier to change. So we have those, I see those as kind of the biggest challenges, especially overcoming the historic way we do things in Connecticut. I see our role in the exchange is to change the way we do things. And in the land of steady habits, a very difficult thing to do right now. One of the lessons is, to me, is to get to know your customer immediately and to engage them in the process. And that includes all customers. I mean, consumers are customers, the people who are buying the product, the providers, even the carriers to some degree have to be engaged so that they can buy in. If I was able to go back, I would say we would have started our deliberations on certain pieces of this much earlier than we did. I mean, I don't think that was anybody's fault. And some of it had to do with changes to rules and things like that. But I would start I would have started immediately with planning our EHB, with addressing issues around affordability. What could we do in addition to just picking plans? Just bringing people around the table earlier, I think, would have been a good thing. I do think for the exchange to succeed in 5 or 10 years, we do have to address the healthcare cost side. We have to address it. So whether it's changing plan design or whether it's, which could be part of it, but more, I think, getting to the core issues around healthcare costs and transparency around pricing and driving down the price of healthcare. Until we get to that, we're not going to have a long-term sustainable exchange or any product, frankly, going forward. So 5 to 10 years, I see it as if it does all those things, it's a highly successful endeavor for the state, and I plan to hope, or I hope to be part of that success. That's my hope.